Barrett Kohler Publishers presents Simple Truths of Leadership, 52 Ways to Be a Servant Leader and Build Trust. Written by Ken Blanchard and Randy Conley. Narrated by Jeff Hoyt. Introduction. Simple Truths. The beginning of my mission statement is, I am a loving teacher and an example of simple truths. That focus has been central in all of my work, including the study of servant leadership. I have always looked for simple truths that reflect common sense practices people can use to make their work and life, as well as the lives of the people they care about, happier and more satisfying. To that end, I find it fun and inspiring to work with co-authors who share a similar philosophy, because I have always found that 1 + 1 is greater than 2. That's certainly been the case as I have worked on this book with Randy Conley. Randy's focus over the last 15 years has been on distilling the complex topic of trust into simple, actionable principles that help people experience more authentic and fulfilling relationships. In recognition of his work, Trust Across America awarded Randy a Lifetime Achievement Award for being a top thought leader in the field of trust. In addition, Inc.com named him a top 100 leadership speaker and thinker. When it comes to servant leadership and trust, we both wonder why the principles we see as common sense are so seldom used in common practice. If today's leaders had a more common sense approach to leadership, we'd venture to say that 65% to 70% of the workforce would not be considered disengaged. That's one reason our original title for this book was, Duh, Why Isn't Common Sense Leadership Common Practice? Another reason is that when I would mention that title to audiences, they'd roar with laughter as they recognized the truth in the title. I would immediately get questions about when the book was going to be available. However, when our publisher, Barrett Kohler, sent out a survey about possible titles and subtitles, two things were clear. First, the word duh doesn't translate well from English to other languages. And second, a favorite title rose to the top, Simple Truths of Leadership, 52 Ways to Be a Servant Leader and Build Trust, with the cover tagline, Making Common Sense Common Practice. We wrote this book because we know a lot of people aren't applying common sense leadership principles in the workplace. The format for the audiobook is simple. First, we identify a simple truth about servant leadership or trust. Then, we describe the puzzling lack of use of the concept and briefly explain why it is important. The final element is a call to action for listeners, making common sense common practice, where we break down the concept into ideas that leaders can easily apply on the job. When common sense leadership is put into practice, everybody wins: leaders, their people, and their organizations. We've divided the simple truths we are sharing into two parts: servant leadership, which features me, and building trust, which features Randy. We have two reasons for doing this. When servant leadership is effectively implemented, trust abounds among leaders and their people. Servant leadership and trust go hand in hand. These two topics highlight our respective areas of expertise. You can use this audiobook in several ways. Listen to the simple truths in order, pick one truth and listen and apply each week of the year, or jump to a subtopic that interests you most. At the end of the audiobook, you'll find a discussion guide for exploring the concepts further with your team. We hope you'll enjoy listening to our audiobook and making some of these simple truths an integral part of your leadership style. If you do, we know it will make a difference in your life and the lives of the people you influence. Part 1. Servant Leadership. In this part, Ken Blanchard takes the lead with a focus on his lifelong passion of servant leadership as an influence process in which leaders help their people accomplish goals.
Much of my work in the past was focused on leadership behavior and how to improve leadership style and methods. My colleagues and I attempted to change leaders from the outside, but in recent years, we have found that effective leadership is an inside job. It's a question of the heart. It's all about a leader's character and intention. Why are you leading? Is it to serve or be served? Answering this question truthfully is so important that I co-edited a book with Renee Broadwell entitled Servant Leadership in Action: How You Can Achieve Great Relationships and Results. In it, 45 key leaders in our field, including Simon Sinek, Brené Brown, and Marshall Goldsmith, share their points of view about servant leadership. The essence of that book is you can't fake being a servant leader. The most persistent barrier to being a servant leader is a heart motivated by self-interest that looks at the world as a give a little, take a lot proposition. Self-serving leaders put their own agenda, safety, status, and gratification ahead of others who are impacted by the leader's thoughts and actions. The shift from self-serving leadership to leadership that serves others is motivated by a change of heart. If leaders don't get their heart right, they will never become servant leaders. A misguided heart will color their thinking, impact their behavior, and cause them to begin every day by asking, "What's in it for me today?" That's certainly not servant leadership. In this part, you will learn more about servant leadership and the power it has to make the world a better place by focusing on the greater good.
The essence of servant leadership. Simple truth number one. Servant leadership is the best way to achieve both great results and great relationships. Organizational leaders often have an either-or attitude toward results and people. For example, leaders who focus only on results may have trouble creating great relationships with their people, and leaders who focus mainly on relationships may have trouble getting desired results. Yet, you can get both great results and great relationships if you understand the two parts of servant leadership. The leadership aspect focuses on vision, direction, and results, where you as a leader hope to take your people. Leaders should involve others in setting direction and determining desired results, but if people don't know where they're headed or what they're meant to accomplish, the fault lies with the leader. The servant aspect focuses on working side by side in relationship with your people. Once the vision and direction are clear, the leader's role shifts to service, helping people accomplish the agreed-upon goals. Making common sense common practice. This 1-2 punch of the aspects of servant leadership enables you to create both great results and great relationships. 1. Let your people know what they're being asked to do by setting the vision and direction with their help. In other words, vision and direction, while the responsibility of the leader, is not a top-down process. And 2, during implementation, assure your people you are there to serve, not to be served. Your responsibility is to help them accomplish their goals through training, feedback, listening, and communication. It's important for servant leaders to establish this both-and mindset toward results and relationships. Simple truth number 2. Every great organization has a compelling vision. When I explain what a compelling vision is to some leaders in organizations, they either give me a blank look or say something like, "I'm sure we have one on the wall somewhere." So, what is a compelling vision? According to my book with Jesse Stoner, Full Steam Ahead: Unleash the Power of Vision in Your Work and Your Life, a compelling vision includes three elements: your purpose, what business you are in, your picture of the future, where you are going, and your values, what will guide your journey. A compelling vision is alive and well in companies that are leaders in their field, such as Disney, Southwest Airlines, Nordstrom, Wegmans, and Starbucks. Making common sense common practice. here's how you can incorporate the three elements of a compelling vision in your organization. Make sure the people in your organization know what business they are in. For example, when Walt Disney started his theme parks, he said, "We are in the happiness business." Confirm that your people know where they are going, what good results would look like. At Disney, the picture of the future is that all guests of the parks would have the same smile on their faces when leaving as when they entered. And find out if the people in your organization are clear on what values will guide their journey. Disney's first value is safety. Its next values are courtesy and the show, which is about everyone playing their parts perfectly, whether they are a ticket taker or Mickey Mouse. Disney's final value is efficiency, having a well-run, profitable organization. If you can share your compelling vision as clearly as Disney does, congratulations, you have just made common sense common practice. Simple truth number 3. Servant leaders turn the traditional pyramid upside down. Most organizations and leaders get into trouble during the implementation phase of servant leadership if the traditional hierarchical pyramid is used. When that happens, whom do people think they work for? The people above them. The minute you think you work for the person above you, you assume that person, your boss, is responsible, and your job is to be responsive to your boss's whims or wishes. Boss watching can become a popular sport where people get promoted based on their upward influencing skills. As a result, all the energy of the organization moves up the hierarchy, away from customers and the frontline folks who are closest to the action.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.